Daddy. Today I've been learning some. I survived. I seriously had to go check my thing because I lost my page. But I'm on chapter 9, so yay, it's part 9, and let's get on with the reading. Yeah. Dr. Day helped Death up and practically dragged him to the car. By the time Dex was in his seat, the hail had stopped. Dr. Gage opened the glove compartment and took out a first aid kit. He fished out an ice pack, gave it a good smack, laid it gently on the painful lump on Dex's scalp. "Are you sure you're all right?" Dr. Gage said. His brow crinkled up with worry. "I'm fine," Dex said, and luckily he was. He just hoped Mom wouldn't run out. "I'm so sorry, Dex. I never should have put us in the middle of that field from the radar. I actually thought the storm was going to lose power. I should have known better. I think your car is in worse shape than me," Dex said. A hailstone had turned the windshield into a spider web of cracks. Dr. Gage laughed. I've had it replaced twice this year already." They sat for a few minutes until the rain stopped. "It always surprises me," Dr. Gage said. "Nature can be so violent 1 minute and so peaceful the next. And we humans have no control at all." Dr. Gage opened his door and sat outside. A few seconds later, he came back holding a huge hailstone, perfectly round and glistening. He presented it to Dex as though it was a priceless diamond. "A souvenir." It was very light and smooth, Dex brought it up to his nose and sniffed it. It smelled musty, and he caught a whiff of something strangely familiar. Dr. Gage seemed to read his mind. "Mint, right? That's it," Dex said. "I wish I could tell you why. We can put it in my little freezer until we get home." Dex had already decided he'd bring it to school tomorrow. He'd pack it in a small cooler and show it to the guys at lunch. Dylan would freak. Dr. Gage turned his attention to the weather radar map. He pointed to the two red blotches pushing across the screen. "Look at these," he said. "You surprised me? There are two new storms heading this way. We're both are supercells." His face darkened. "It's going to get dangerous around here when all of these storms come together. Jimmy and Sarah love this kind of weather, but I think it's too risky to be out here chasing. I can't tell where these storms are heading and how strong they're going to get." He looked at Dex apologetically. "I think we should head back to Joplin and call it a day." Okay, there's two more pages until chapter 10. "That's fine," Dex said, trying to not to sound too relieved. That lightning had spooked him, and that hailstone had almost cracked up in his skull. He'd seen enough bad weather for one day. Dex realized he'd relaxed on the ride back to Joplin as Dr. Gage told him funny stories about himself and Dad in college. But as they got closer to Dex's neighborhood, Dr. Gage got quiet. He kept one eye on the radar map, kept glancing wearily onto the rearview mirror. Was someone following them? Was Dr. Gage going to get a speeding ticket? Tex turned around, expecting to see flashing police lights. There were no cars behind them, but there was something strange in the sky, an enormous dark cloud moving very quickly toward them. Shiver of fear tangled Dex's scalp. Is that a super cell? Could be, Dr. Gage said. There's so much happening on the radar right now, it's hard to. No, it's pretty far back. Let's see if we can take a better look. He made a quick U-turn so that now they were driving slowly in the opposite direction toward the cloud. It was very dark with a hazy blur in the center, stretched out across the horizon as far as Dex could see. Dr. Gage stared though. The cracked windshield scanning the sky like a seal screeching for enemy shooters. And then a flash of lightning flared inside the club, lighting up from inside like an X-ray. Oh my lord, Dr. Gage whispered in a split second of brightness. They had both seen what's hidden inside of a storm cloud. It was a tornado, an enormous chunturing tornado, the biggest Dex had ever imagined. It was on a path to destroy Joplin. And I'm sorry if this do seem a little cruddy. I do have allergies. And yeah. So we're on chapter 10 of 15. We have 5 more of these videos to go. So yeah. Bye guys. I love you.